So, motovloggers, should you buy the E4K action cam? Watch the full video to find out. Run free and dive into the sky. No, the E4K has been around from almost 1.5 years and there are a ton of great reviews about this product. What I wanna focus here is the problems or glitches faced by motovloggers from this camera. So, let's not waste any time and get started immediately. Lack of a Wi-Fi button. So, as you can see, there is no Wi-Fi button which can be switched on and off like the ones we have in the GoPros. The lack of this button makes you want to open the waterproof case every time you want to connect it to your phone. Opening this case very frequently poses a problem which will be discussed later in this video. Secondly, the major problem I faced was when my screen had cracked and I couldn't use the camera because I couldn't change the modes to video mode or maybe time-lapse mode. A Wi-Fi button there would have made my life a whole lot easier. Crack in the waterproof case. Frequent opening of the case will cause a crack near the latch, as you can see right here. A simple case like the ones in the earlier GoPros would have been more than enough, but no. E had to show off some innovation here. This will make you wanna buy a new case which is almost 3000 rupees. Of course, a simple Fevikwik would solve the problem, but I'm not sure how good it'll hold. The LED light is too small. Have you ever been in a situation where you look at the mirror to make sure if your camera is on and if your camera is recording? Of course, every motovlogger would have faced this problem. In fact, there's no camera that does the job well with respect to this problem. But E4K LED light is too damn small to be seen. Sometimes even if you look in the mirror, you'll not know the status of the camera. The first version of the E-cam had made a good LED light ring around the button. That is far better than this tiny LED in terms of functionality. No external mic. Lastly, the lack of external mic supportivity makes a motovlogger think again before buying this camera. Of course, there are lots and lots of advantages to this camera. This video was just an elaboration of the minor problems that the camera poses. Go ahead and leave your thoughts or comments about this topic and add points if any. If this video helped you make a good decision, go ahead and click that like button. And if it's your first time on this channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.